Hello folks and welcome Linux Mint 21.2 Cinnamon Desktop. So today I'm going to talk about login screens. A lot of times maybe you don't want to see that black and white Linux Mint logo. You want something colorful. Well, I'm going to show you a couple of different things you can think about. You can pick the standard wallpapers that you can normally pick from backgrounds and also add your own. In addition to that, I will also show you how to put a custom mouse pointer or cursor in that selection area. Because normally, you, even if you have a custom mouse or a mouse installed in your .icons folder, it's not available in your login screen. But I'll show you how to make it available. All right. So in either case, folks, I'm going to do this very slowly. And anyone can do this. So welcome folks, Linux Mint 21.2 Cinnamon. And if you're brand new to Cinnamon, a special welcome to you. So I'm gonna use Alt and F4 to close the welcome screen, and I'm going to open up my settings. So as you can see, I've got some other wallpaper changed, but I'm gonna talk about the login screen. So you can right click on your panel bar, and if you're brand new to Mint, this is your panel. System settings here. Or go to the Mint menu and go find your system settings. In either case, scroll to the bottom in the admin section and look for login window. Now, there are a lot of things I can do in here. I'm going to open this by first putting in my password. Now, a lot of these things that I'm about to show you do require that you have the capability of installing programs. In other words, you can't be a standard user, a restricted user. And if you're the only user on the system, then of course it's your standard password. Now, the first thing that you'll notice on the login window, if you don't mind, I'll close that, is the background. Okay, what am I using for a background? Well, I'm using something very different. I added this. Okay, so you will come up with a default backgrounds of user share backgrounds. And if you click the center section, normally, this is where you're at. You're probably at this default, or maybe the black and white one. I'm not sure which one. I believe it's this one here. Okay, but you can see I'm selecting a whole bunch of stuff in here. So if you click the backgrounds, you can also select different Linux Mint folders, if you want to call it that. And some of these are very nice for your login screens, by the way. It's better than looking at that black and white thing. Now, if you're one of those folks that have the limited size laptop screens or whatever else, then think about the image sizes also. All right. But maybe you do want it just the black and white one. But again, I'm just giving you some options. So what I did in here is these are the standard ones that come with your system, but I added this one in here. And I'll show you how to do that. To add your own image. But I'm not done yet. So basically, I'm going to go back and I'm going to pick something, maybe that one, and then hit open. So that becomes your default when you do your login, logout for your standard user. Okay, so we have mouse pointer. As you notice that I have radioactive in this menu. You normally, even though I've got it installed in .icons, it's not available in this menu. That is because this mouse pointer normally is not installed in my USR share icons folder. And I'll show you how to install that also, in case you want to put your own custom mouse pointer that you're currently using that you got installed in your .icons folder. So two things to think about. And don't forget the size of the pointer. Now, continuing on, I'm going to come back to these two items. Continuing on, you have also users. Allow manual login, hide the user list. And this is my least favorite, is allow guest sessions. Okay. And then auto logins, you can certainly do that. But I will also discourage you from doing that also, because the fact is, you want to keep your system with a username and password. Just for security reasons, but it's your system. You would put in your name. All right, and then you have some other options and settings. high dots per inch support, you probably want that to auto. And then your login screen has some stuff at the top if you've never noticed it. You can actually disable stuff like that. That would be your host name, the name of your computer, and the accessibility options, and et cetera, et cetera. Yes, you can even customize the clock format. If you're not too sure what these elements are, you can go and find your time and date on your bottom down here. Hit configure. Just do this temporarily. Slide this to custom, and there be show information on date, format, syntax. It goes to Mike's website for goodstirftime.com, and you can look at the reference elements in here. Okay, and then you can slide that back off. So this would be those elements. Okay. All right, let's get back to backgrounds. How do I add a background if I wanted to? Again, there are plenty of options in here that you can just use the defaults. But let's say you wanted to add, like in this folder right here, the Victoria folder, like a custom image. All right, I'm going to close this window. I'm going to open up my file manager at this point. All right, so file manager for this distribution is, of course, Nemo. So the first thing to do is to decide, do you want an image on your login screen that is non-standard? Well, if you do, then where is it stored? So, and what kind of image do you want to use? I'll use, let me make this larger for you. And hopefully you've seen my videos on how to do stuff like that, you know, resizing stuff on the fly. If not, you can always do it the old-fashioned way. All right, I'm going to take and copy this image right here. This is a small image. And I'm not sure what size this thing is. It's a 1920 by 1080. So the same screen resolution I'm filming in. And by the way, if you need to adjust your screen resolution accordingly, you can do that on your gear, on your YouTube player. All right, right click, copy. Now let's go find your file system. Now, before I get in here, I am going to forewarn you. Be very careful about what I'm about to show you. All right, be very careful in here because you're going to open this file manager in root mode. And when you do that, you should be very careful about adding and removing any files and folders. Right click, open as root. So providing I punched in my password the first time, it says elevated privileges. This is where things get a little hairy. Be very careful in here one more time. Okay. So basically I'm going to go to USR, share, and look for backgrounds. All right. So there's lots of folders in here. They're alphabetical. Okay. So as you're looking around, we're looking for backgrounds. And we have backgrounds right here next to AWK. You have three folders. You have Linux Mint, you have Linux Mint Vanessa and Victoria. I am going to put that image in the same space I put on number 6, which is that other image that I shown you. And I'm going to hit paste. Okay. Now the second thing that I'm about to show you in here is mouse pointers next, cursors. It's not everybody's cup of tea, but close the file manager when you get done doing this. Right click, system settings, login window, and let's go check that. Now click that image there, backgrounds, Victoria, open that, and there's that image. This could be, of course, any image, and you can see the size of it. Okay, and there are lots of nice looking images in here too. I'm going to leave this one as a matter of fact. All right, so for you folks that want to get adventuresome about the mouse pointer, let me show you that one. So in general, I have installed in the past, and I've shown this on many of my videos, Control H shows hidden files and folders. And I've shown you how to install mouse cursors in this area here. Okay, there are many things that I can throw in here. I can throw in mouse pointers, or I can also do like candy icons and stuff. I have lots of videos on my YouTube site. But if your mouse cursor is currently installed here, you can also copy it. So I will find another mouse cursor like Azenus, for instance. And I'm going to show you that that is not in this menu. So I'm going to go to the login window one more time. Log in here and let you see the selection of mouse pointer in the login window, if you care about this. So Azenus is not in this list. Why is that? Because it's not installed in .icons. I'm sorry, in USR share icons. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this. Because it's in .icons, my locally logged in user. And this folder has the ownership of you or me or whoever the name of this user. My user for today is Bob. So Bob owns all the stuff in here. Okay. However, Bob does not own any of these folder in here, USR, share. And this is a different folder. It's icons. He doesn't own anything in here. This, you have to have root permissions to add and remove. Okay. So the radioactive mouse pointer is in here. So if I try to do a paste, it's grayed out. If I try to do a delete, it's grayed out, move to trash. Okay, so that means I got to be in root mode to get in here. So let's go through this procedure one more time. So I'm going to first copy the mouse pointer here under dot icons. This will be the Azenus, right? Copy. File system. Right click in the blank area. Open as root. Again, be very careful in here. All right, USR, share, all my videos have timelines and chapters. You're in elevated privileges, so be very careful in here. All right, what I'm looking for is icons. You can just scroll for it if you don't want to use, just type in I. But it is under the I sections, and right next to I18N is icons. So again, these are the folders that are normally protected by root permissions. Right click, paste. Now, as soon as you do that, it goes over and puts it in the A section. Get out of the file manager. Okay. Now, I am going to go ahead and right click, system settings, scroll down, login window. Now Radioactive is available, and also Azenus. So I put it in, so all of these are coming from USR share icons folder. When you are choosing a mouse pointer or cursor, it is done through themes. Okay, it's done through here. The system is smart enough to go to two locations. It goes and looks in your .icons folder, in your locally logged in user, and the other mouse cursors also come from USR share icons. The system knows to look for both locations. Okay. This one and this one is now installed with the rest of these things. They're installed with your system. And when you do stuff like that, if you have additional users, they will also get that mouse cursor or mouse pointer. Again, I have a complete video on my YouTube site on how to do this, how to install mouse cursors and pointers. I even tell you a nonprofit website where you can get them from. But more importantly, if you create another user, they can also have these now available to them instead of having it installed in .icons. But if you don't care about that on your login screen, then at least just be aware that you can change your background picture through here. Okay. And don't forget, you can click the folder before it and change folders. So you have three things to play with. So again, if you wanted to add your own image in this folder, you'll need to do that former procedure that I showed earlier. You have to be in root mode to add anything in this USR share backgrounds folders. But I will tell you, in most cases, you'll have plenty of images to play with. And there are a lot of gorgeous login screen type of pictures in here. So that's what I'm leaving. And don't forget, if you want the cursor size larger or smaller, depending on your screen resolution, of course, but you can do that in here. And you can see that I'm using Radioactive also as I'm using this mouse pointer or cursor. Thank you for watching.